If you're a digital photographer, you probably have tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of images. And if you're anything like most people, you probably feel a bit out of control. Today, I'm going to show you how to start taking back control of your image library. Hello, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. Today, I'm looking at a problem facing most photographers, which is how to better organise your photos. In particular, I want to show you how to use folders and collections to start getting back some control. And whilst I'm using Lightroom, you can use this approach with any photo library software that supports collections, and that's most of them. I've also published an accompanying tutorial on my website, and I'll include the link to this in the YouTube video description. Now, I want you to imagine that you've just come back from a photo shoot and you want to download your images. What you want to avoid is just dumping everything into the same folder along with all your other photos. Instead, you'll need a folder structure that's easy to handle, makes sense to you, and importantly, grows as you shoot more photos. There are a lot of different approaches you could use, but I'm going to look at a date-based folder structure. At the top, we have a single folder that's going to hold all the other folders we create. Below this, we have a new folder for each year. Notice that I'm using the year as the start of the folder name to help list the folders in date order. Then, within each year, there's a separate folder for each shoot. This time, the folder name starts with the date in the format of year, month, and day. This again helps to order the folders by date. The folder name also includes a shoot name to help me quickly recognise it. Now, because I'm a landscape photographer, I've used the location of the shoot, but you can use anything that you'll easily recognise. When I come back from a shoot, I create the shoot folder and use it to store all my images from that shoot. It's a simple way to keep my images organised, and it's a system that grows with me. It's the basic structure I have in place to hold all my RAW files. But what happens when I want to edit one of these? Where do I save the finished image or master file? Well, it makes sense to save it to the same location as the original RAW file. That way, I can keep the two together as well as any other variants that I create. But this does give me a problem. How can I easily see and organise all my finished master files? This is where collections can help. Let's look at a basic example where I want to organise all my finished photos ready to add to a website. I can use collections to create a structure to hold my finished photos without it affecting my folders or the actual image files. I'll start by adding a top-level collection set, and I'll call it Website Gallery. This is going to hold all my collections and images for the website. Collection sets are just a way of grouping related collections together, and they're a bit like folders on your computer. Next, I'll add a landscape collection set inside the website gallery set. I can use the location setting to pick where to add the new collection set. I'll then add two more collection sets called Urban and Abstract. Collection sets are very flexible because you can organise them into hierarchies, which is something you can't do with collections. What I've created is a simple structure to organise my photos. Now I can add my collections to these sets to represent individual galleries on the website. I'll start by adding a Peak District collection to the landscape set. Notice that I'm creating a collection and not a smart collection. I'll be looking at smart collections in a future video because they take a little bit more setting up. In addition to the Peak District collection, I'll create another one for Lake District and for Scotland. Rather than continuing to build this structure further, I'll jump to the next step and I'll add some images. I'll go to the Folders panel and browse through my images until I find one I want to add to a collection. I can then click and drag the image onto the collection. When I see the collection name turn blue, I can release the mouse button to add the image. Another way to add a photo to a collection is by clicking to select it. I can then right-click on the collection and choose the option to add. A third way to add a photo to a collection is by setting the collection as a target. You can do this by right-clicking the collection and picking the option from the pop-up. When the collection's set as the target, you'll see a small plus icon to the right of the name. Now when I find an image or images that I want to add to that collection, I can select them and right-click. I then choose the Add to Target Collection option from the menu. Or, even easier, I can just press B on my keyboard. Now you have your images in the collection, you can view them by selecting the collection or collection set. If I pick a collection, Lightroom displays the images in that collection. But if I pick a collection set, it displays everything below that set in the structure. Let's say that I now want to create a book for my website using some of my finished images. I can create myself a separate collection set for that. As before, I'll create the top level collection set first and call this website book. Then I'll duplicate one of the collections that I want to include from the website gallery set. Notice the duplicate collection has the same images as the original. I can then drag the duplicated collection over to the new book collection set to move it. Whilst both collections are showing the same images, I haven't created any new images. They're both showing the original master file that hasn't moved. If I were to edit the master file to update it, the updated version would then show up in both collections. Next, I'll delete the website book collection set using this minus icon. But this doesn't delete the original master file. That's still safe in the folder along with the original raw file. It also doesn't delete the image from any of the other collections. Collections are a great tool for managing your image library efficiently. As I said earlier, I've published a tutorial on my website fully explaining collections. You'll find a link to this in the YouTube video description. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you soon for another video.